Hello and welcome to this quick video where we look at getting started with NewsWhip Spike. We'll cover the first steps after logging in, understanding the user interface and introducing you to dashboard templates and our curated searches. By the end, you should feel confident navigating the product. Now, you should have received an email invitation to access NewsWhip Spike. Please feel free to log in to follow along with the videos or contact our customer success team if you have any issues. This is the landing page of NewsWhip Spike. Your team may have shared some dashboards with you, but otherwise this area will be empty. Dashboards are the main workspace in NewsWhip Spike. You use them to view multiple widgets for one or more searches simultaneously. We'll look at these in more detail later, but for now let's jump in and have a look. The easiest way to get started and to see how the product works is by using a dashboard template with one of our curated searches. The three pre-configured dashboard templates are Monitoring, Crisis, and Research. All are optimized for their particular use case. The default widgets are shown for each. Monitoring is ideal for monitoring a topic or brand across the web and all major social networks. Crisis can be used to track how media and public interest in a crisis is evolving. And research is best used to understand how interest in an event or topic is changing over time, with a longer time period set as default. These can all be selected for a custom search or with one of our curated searches. Curated searches give you access to a growing library of pre-built searches carefully curated by our experienced research team. These are the key events, topics, and trends that we know will be of interest to you. You can see we have topics ranging from labour issues here in research, recalls in crisis, and events in monitoring. You can also choose to view all in each section. You can see all the options available to you. Now, as I'm in monitoring, I think I'll select the events tag. I can see an option here for the World Cup in Qatar, which I know will become a hot topic, so I'll select that. Here we can see our first dashboard with our widgets displaying information about Qatar and the World Cup. We have web articles, Facebook posts, Reddit posts, and tweets. They are displaying all information about either the FIFA World Cup or Qatar World Cup from the previous week. Now you can choose to add or remove some of these search terms over here to fine-tune the search to your unique needs. I'll leave it for now and we'll cover it later. If we scroll down here, we can see some of the big stories this week. We can see a big story about the Danish national team's kit as a means of protest. So they were trying to not show their badge as a means of protest about the World Cup. And we can imagine that there's similar stories like this in the run-up to the World Cup. However, if we look over to Facebook, we can see that the official page is obviously leading with some more football-focused content, such as Lionel Messi. Now, there is a lot more to dive into, but this is really just a taster of what a dashboard can offer. I now have a best practice suggestion for getting started. Ask your team if they have already created dashboards suited for your role. If so, you can request them to copy and share it with you. In any case, please follow the rest of the training to understand the process of creating your own, and perhaps you can share with others in future. We'll look at how to create and refine your own search in the next video. Thanks for watching.